This video is about changing an intank pump. This one is a Picasso. As you can see, there's a filter on the bottom which is tending to get blocked up. There's another small filter on the end of the pump which also gets blocked up. So what we're aiming to do is to just have a straight pipe down to the bottom of this reservoir, and then we'll remove this pump, which is problematic. Second pump has been installed. To drain the fuel from your tank, first of all you'll probably need to siphon some fuel away, and then to take the last sort of 10-15 litres, we cut the top off a 20 litre container, or you could use a 25 litre or 20 litre depending on what you have available. Underneath, to remove the tank, we'll just under this Jubilee clip, we'll place our drainage container underneath, and then we'll have to remove the exhaust heat cover. That'll have to be taken out. The handbrake cables will just have to be uncoupled from the wire frames. These literally just pull out. And then we'll need to remove these two bolts, and then there's one bolt at either end, which are 13mm. Those will have to be screwed, and the plastic tank comes out really easy. If you jack up your car, always be sure to use axle stands. Never ever rely on a hydraulic jack. Once you've drained the tank, you'll need to pop off all of the bands that secure the pipes, and the band at the back that secures the cable, and this will enable you to lower the tank down. So you pull the tank forward and lower it down, and then we can get at the pump inside the tank. You'll need to remove the wires and the pipes from the top of the pump. The wires is a single plug, and then we have the return, and the larger one is the feed, and then the collar around the pump. There's a plastic collar that screws anti-clockwise. When you remove the pump, replace the wires back in the socket, and by doing this you can determine which one is live and which one is negative. As you can see, the one on the right hand side is the live, which makes our wire the grey one for the live connection to the new pump. To remove the wires, we need to remove this plastic cover. Little clips on the side, this will expose the wires. So we remove the cover. Having removed the old pump, now reinsert the holder, and we're going to be using a piece of stiff wire which we'll cable tie to hold the tube down to the bottom of the tank. Once the pipe has been disconnected from the oil, we'll use a Stanley knife to cut the terminal off the pump. Take your piece of steel wire, put down to the top of the housing, and take a measurement at the end of the spring housing. Place your metal rod at the bottom of the housing and secure with a cable tie. Place your metal rod at the top of the housing as shown, and secure with several cable ties and we'll also cable tie the flexible hose. We've used three cable ties, one at the top of the housing, one at the bottom of the nylon housing, and one to secure the bottom of the flexi pipe. At the bottom, we need to trim off the bottom of the flexi pipe, leaving sufficient on the bottom so that the pipe bends to the side, and this will prevent the bottom of the pipe actually being blocked. We now need to bend our wire so that the tube actually goes down into the pump housing. This is how the end of your pipe should look, secured with a cable tie. So it's standing proud of this clip, which fixes on the rim of the old pump. I've assembled the pump. As you can see, the pipe is fitted inside and it's level with the bottom. Underneath the Picasso, next to the tank, and this is the wiring, and we'll be using the two thicker wires. The two thicker wires, the green and yellow is the earth, in this case the blue, which was grey in the tank, is the positive, and the two thinner wires are the sender wires for the unit, for the tank gauge, fuel gauge. But there's a 10mm stud located exactly where the you know would be ideal suited for the pump. So we're going to make use of this. I've now bent the two brackets, and it marries up nicely in the corner. The pump is now secure. We used a self-tapping bolt in that bottom hole, and a 10mm bolt, a 10mm nut in the stud that was sticking out. So fortunately, no holes needed to be drilled. We need to cut this pipe now and join the pipes to the pump. When you cut the pipe, obviously fuel is going to be draining out, so place your drain bucket underneath. Pump is now secured in place, and we've placed two tight cable ties on each end. I've had to warm the pipe up to get the right bending with the hairdryer. And now all that's left is to connect the two wires to the spray connector supplied, and we've fitted the wire inside the protective cable. It's a bit noisier than the pump in the tank.
As it turns out, the pump we installed wasn't man enough for the job. It needed to be a 3-bar pump, so we had to reorder a 3.5 bar pump.
Using a piece of wood that's roughly the size of the fuel pump that we're going to use to make our bracket, and opening the jaws of the vise so there's plenty of play around either side, we'll form the copper tube around the wood. So using a hammer, we drive the piece of timber down through the vise, and this will cause the copper tubing, flattened copper tubing, to curl around the... And then we'll turn our timber around. And pinch the copper tubing so that it forms a flat area on the other side. When we tighten the and tighten the vise, it closes our clamp. Has to be quite brutal. When we've formed our bracket, we need to saw off. Here's the pump in place. We've added some tape around the outside of the body, still a snug fit. So that's ordinary insulation tape, and that will give us a bit of a anti-vibration. Wiring we've connected up at the other end with two sprayed connectors. We'll put a couple of cable ties on the end just to secure the pipe. Hopefully all should be well. The pump's all wired up. We'll just give it a try. Turn it over. There's a pump priming itself. Start it up. The most important thing with the pump is to make sure the pressure is the right bar. The Picasso, this is a 3-bar pump. This pump is actually a 3.5 bar. It's a little bit noisier because it's on the outside of the tank, but what we'll do is we'll lever it away from the body and we'll put a bit of silicone down the back of the pump and down the front of the pump, and that will take a lot of the vibrations away. Changing the pump, you shouldn't spill a single drop of fuel. Disconnect the pipes, reconnect the pipes, don't have to empty the tank. It just makes so much sense. When this pump packs up, it'll cost me £35 to replace. When the Picasso pump packs up, it costs £130 plus a whole lot of hassle taking the tank out, emptying the fuel, getting in an awful mess. This is the way to go.